Hello! FoxTrek64 here again, back with more Pokemon Red. Okay, here's what you missed. I've got two new Pokemons. I have an epically badass Lapras. Oh yeah. And I've got a freaking annoying Dratini that I'm trying to level up right now. So I went around and I beat pretty much every single person in the Silvco building, except for the boss, which I'm about to go do. Oh, and this person over here. Yeah, I didn't beat him yet. Forgot about that. Sorry. Oh well. Yeah, you also missed the rival battle, but it was easy anyway. Boring. Alright, now what I've been doing with Simophane is basically just the switch and pull method. If you call it that, I don't know what people call it. Yeah, Bone Club's not gonna work. Too bad I'm in the air. Gonna have to do sort of a somewhat quick video here, because I'm about to eat dinner in about 20 minutes or so. Which is about how long these videos usually are, so I figured, you know, might as well record it. Maybe make it a little bit shorter than that. I've been having trouble trying to figure out how to, like, convert my video files into HD. Because, like, all my converting programs keep messing up on me. I figured out a way to bypass the audio and video desync that CamStudio usually does with its AVI files. And it also keeps the file size from being so effing big. It makes the frame rate a little bit worse, but it's definitely worth it. But then after that, I'm trying to figure out, you know, how do I convert it to an HD video? And I have some programs that claim to be able to do that, but this one that I'm using, Any Video Converter, it converts pretty much any kind of video into any kind of video. And you can, like, select your own, size and everything, but for some reason, whenever I tried to do that, it made the bitrate really messed up. And basically the entire video played in 13 seconds, but the audio was still going at normal speed, so it was only a 13 second long video for some reason, even though it was in HD. So I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do about that. Who's poisoned? Oh, Charbers is. Well, do I have a full heal? Yeah, I do. Okay. Good. Now that I have a water type, Giovanni's gonna be easy as hell. Basically, if you have any kind of water type or grass type on your team at all, Giovanni is easy. Because he uses crap like that. But for now, I can just send out Zaptail. After that thing's a Nidoking, its Earthquake is gonna be like a bitch, but, you know, if you can get by that, which isn't that hard to do, send out a Charizard or something. Then it's not that difficult. Kangaskhan. How is Kangaskhan not a ground type? I mean, really, it needs to be a ground type. It really does. And get that derpy smile off its face, too. Jeez. Let's switch out to Peril, I guess. Normal types don't work. Psychic to the face. Or the head, or brain, whatever you want to say. I don't know. Man, today's Sunday, and it's already like 4 p.m. I don't have a whole lot of time left to do this recording session, and this is only the second video I've gotten done, because it keeps messing up on me. So I need to, seriously, why did I just switch out to Zaptail? That's fucking stupid. Well, I'm afraid if I switch out to Simophane to give it the experience points, I might get killed. I guess not. Alright. Now that we've switched out to everybody in the frickin' world, let's just switch back to Peril and use Mega Drain. Easy. Yeah, see, I'm even a little bit behind on my levels and this guy's easy. Nidoqueen, still easy. If Simofame was fast enough, I could probably beat that Nidoqueen just using rap. Let's see if that'll work. Oh no, it won't, it won't, it won't, it won't. I'm not fast enough. Okay, Corlick, your turn. I named the Lapras Corlick because Holly has a Lapras OC named Corlick. And as you know, I named pretty much all of my Pokemans after OCs. Except for Simofane. I don't have a, like, no one has a Dragonite OC that I know of, so. I named it after the Dragonite on my white version on my Dragon-type team. It's pretty badass, but it's not an OC. I lost again? Well, yeah, what do you expect? Blast it all, you ruined our plans for Sylph! But Team Rocket will never fall. Well, until I beat you in your own gym and then you break up for 3 years. You know, there's just that. And now this guy gives us a Master Ball. Fuck yes, Master Ball. Oh yeah, what now, bitch? Now, if we find a shiny wild Abra, we will be prepared. But I don't think that's gonna happen because shinies didn't exist in this game, unfortunately. Well, now we're done here. Might as well go over to the gym in the fake gym in Saffron and then move on to Fuchsia. Which I already did to get the Dratini, obviously, but I managed to take the cycling road and not battle any trainers on the way there, so, yeah. For now, over to the fighting type gym. After I heal. Man. Just cranking those 8-bit nostalgia themes, I swear. It's really great going back and playing these old games. Then again, it's also pretty great going back and playing Emerald again. Which I will continue that LP, I swear, I just have to finish the intro for it first. Because at the rate I'm going, it's like, well, the LP's gonna be done before the intro is, and then I'll never get to use it, and I will have done all that work for nothing. I was gonna work on it this weekend, but, you know, all my stuff keeps messing up on me for recording sessions, so I keep having to do videos over again, and it's like, don't have time to animate. What I'm probably gonna end up doing is just skipping this next, gem comic page to animate. I don't see what else I can do, honestly. Because I've not had any time to do that at all. And it sucks. I've been halfway done with it for like, what, 2 months now or something like that? I think it's been about 2 months. So I really want to get it done. You know, then it's like, okay, well it's out of the way and I can continue with the Emerald again. Which I really want to do, because that's like, the OP that I was having the most fun with, to be honest. Flora Sky, I'm not really enjoying all that much, mostly because I feel like I'm doing a really terrible LP of it. And because it's the one that keeps messing up on me the most. So, I know that's not really the game's fault so much as it is mine, but it still just kind of makes you hate it. So, yeah. I mean, with the Pokemon Red videos, nothing is messing up on me so far, like, at all, pretty much. Mostly because there's no color, so the file sizes are not nearly as big on these videos, and I can keep going longer too, so it's getting done faster. I'm already about halfway through the game, pretty much. Or at least close to it. I only have 3 badges, but, you know. Or, no, actually I have 4, so I am about halfway, and I'm about to get 5. Maybe in the next video. I hate leveling up dragons, but it's so worth it in the end. I hear you're good, show me. Okay. I will. Man, I just keep thinking about that lasagna. I pretty much haven't eaten anything all day except for snacks. Like, I snacked on some chips earlier. Well, I had that bowl of cereal, but cereal's not really filling. In fact, it's kind of weird. Whenever I eat cereal during the day, like, usually, if it's not a weekend, if it's a regular day and I eat cereal in the morning, I end up being more hungry toward lunch than if I just don't eat anything. It's really weird. I don't know. Maybe just having something to eat in the morning activates your appetite? I don't know. Because whenever I don't eat in the morning, I'm usually not hungry throughout the rest of the day. But whenever I eat in the morning, it's like I have an appetite throughout the rest of the day, so it's really weird. Especially whenever I eat cereal. It's odd. I don't know. Nintendo Capri Sun and Attacking Toucans both have been kind of talking about, you know, eating healthier and stuff. Apparently, Nintendo Capri Sun drinks, like, 3 sodas a day, or has been drinking about 3 sodas a day. And I'm going, whoa, I thought I drank too much soda. I drink, like, 1 a day, and on the weekends, 2 a day. So, I mean, jeez. It's a good thing he's going to work out at the gym and everything, though. I mean, you know, that's good for him. And then Attacking Toucans tried to do that thing where he wasn't going to eat any meat or drink any soda for, like, a month or 2 months or something. And I must say, I have to applaud him for even attempting to do something like that, because I do not have the capacity to do that. Hey, you guys want to join me? No. No, I do not. I will sit here and happily eat my meat and drink my soda. I don't think I could go for a week without meat, let alone 2 months. And soda? God, no. It bothers me whenever I don't drink soda for 3 days, let alone 2 months. So there's just no way. Oh, by the way, I'm not gonna get either of those Pokemon up there even after I beat all these guys, because I'm not gonna use them, so what's the point? Just to have them sit there? Fuck that. I mean, they're just sitting right there anyway, but with less effort. If that makes any sense. Like, it's easier just to leave them there than it is to go back to the PC, clear space in my party, and then go and put one of them in the PC and get my Pokemon back out. So, might as well just leave them. I'm only doing this for the level grinding. And then after this, on to Saffron Gym. Which I really am not very good at all. I always take, like, the wrong warp tiles, or I don't know which ones to take, or something like that. So, not very good at it. Take your shoes off! No. Dude, maybe it's cold in here. God knows, if you have shoes on, it's a lot easier to stay warm, and if you have shoes off, you get cold. Or at least I do. I'm, like, so sensitive to the temperature, as I've said before. And then in the winter, even when I have shoes and socks on, it's still freezing cold. Like, I cannot get warm. It sucks. It's mainly because the floor is also cold, and it, like, seeps into your feet, which in turn makes the rest of your body cold. And I hate it. There's nothing you can do about the floor being cold. Or at least there's not much you could do. Maybe you could get, like, an electric blanket and land on the floor or something, but then that's a fire hazard, so I don't know. Yeah. I'm not really paranoid about things like that, but still, some people might say, well, you don't want to start a fire. So funny, as I'm sitting here right now, I'm drinking a Coke. My favorite soda probably is RC Cola, and after that Pepsi, and then after that, probably Coke, but... I mean, RC Cola just isn't that common anymore, you never really see it. Alright, let's beat this guy. This whole, like, gym setup in this town never made any sense to me. Like, okay, just because another wannabe gym leader rolls into town and has psychic types, which are good against fighting types, that means you have to quit being a gym? That doesn't make any sense. What if Misty just went into Pewter City and said, you can't be a gym leader anymore because I'm better? I mean, that doesn't make any sense. So, I don't know. Like, wow, those are the rules of this world, and that's really stupid. Finally, a decent move. Jeez, this thing has been learning nothing but crap. Except for Double Edge, but that's a TM move, so that doesn't even count. Alright, let's get a wrap. Get rid of wrap, I meant to say. I think I said get a wrap. It's stupid. I don't want to... Get a wrap for what? It's not cold yet. I don't need to wrap myself up in anything. Wow, Hitmonchan's sprite looks really weird. Then again, I say that as if I'm surprised. The sprites look weird in this game? I had no idea. Yeah, your speed's up, but that's not really gonna get you much, because... Barrel no psychic. Yeah, that's pretty much gonna be an OHKO. Yep. Alright, is that it? Yeah, that is it. Okay. And Simofane's evolving, thank god. I thought it evolved at level 35, but... Maybe that's just now and not back then. Why did it turn white all of a sudden? That's odd. It looks like the colors are reversed on it or something. Indeed, I have lost, but I beseech you, do not take our emblem as your trophy. In return, I will give you a prize to fighting Pokemon. Choose whichever one you like. No thanks, I don't need that. You know what I probably should have done? I probably should have kept it from evolving to make it easier to level up. Oh well. I need to rearrange. I don't really like this setup over here. Like, all the text is way too crowded. You can't really tell what's what that well. It's another thing they've improved. There's not all that black and white just text everywhere that's really crowded. I didn't remember. Okay. Alright, is Sternum still staying out front? Probably. No, not at all. And how is that Tail and Peril doing over there? This video is getting a little bit long. Probably gonna stop. Yeah, I'm gonna stop it. So next time, Saffron Gym. See you later. Bye.